Psychedelics are really good for understanding at the deepest level what is causing the illness.
At this conference, there are anthropologists, there are psychiatrists, there are neuroscientists. It's a whole spectrum.
I've been interested in psychedelic science for a long time, and I thought it's something I could bring to my students at school.
I'm part of a student group. My college paid for me to be here.
I'm very, very interested in the research that's going on and the use of psychedelics in psychotherapy.
They are powerful ego dissolvers that open you up to a much larger, deeper, authentic truths.
I feel that MAPS offers the most marvelous opportunity for the advancement of psychedelic psychotherapy and for the advancement of even peace in the world.
The work that I do is looking at the research done with MDMA for post-traumatic stress disorder.
These conferences are just an enormous advance, and not only for people who are members of MAPS, but people coming in from outside, you know, covering it in the news, and that's one of the big things.
We are part of a non-profit organization in the Amazon rainforest. The institute works to promote the benefits of the indigenous healing traditions in Amazon, how they can be a viable alternative approach towards healing in the Western world as well.
Decir es sobre ayahuasca.
I can tell you about ayahuasca.
Para mí es como una, como una planta sagrada.
It's a sacred substance.
I believe that ayahuasca is a teacher, it's a spiritual teacher.
And I suffer of Lyme disease for 10 years, and I spent a month doing ayahuasca, and I basically healed it through the ceremonies.
Psychedelics like bring you that awareness of, you know, what is my family trauma that I'm continuing to play out that's causing this? Is there some imbalance in my body neurochemically? Sometimes the plants just fix that, and sometimes they'll show you what you need to eat to fix that.
I've been really inspired by finding out about all the research that's currently going on that I didn't know was happening, and so that really makes me happy to hear that this is blooming.
I just see that the sort of dark ages, you know, paranoia and superstition about these things is fading.
I hope that the stigma against psychedelics will be decreased.
I think it's just really cool to see that there's a lot of enthusiasm for this kind of stuff. I mean, you don't hear about entheogen use on television. And I feel like this is like a revolution that will not be televised, or at least not for the time being.
And it's nice to know there are other people who are looking in the field from sort of respectable scientific and intellectual points of view, not just, you know, I dropped acid and watched the walls move.
It's inspiring, it's exciting, and it's encouraging.